it's on sale for pre-orders, and the book signing is May 19th, so I'm very excited about that. If any of you are available to come on out to 911 Massachusetts Avenue, Indianapolis, Indiana, on May 19th from 3 to 5 p.m., and I'll be there, Denita Brown, signing the book. But I just wanted to share with you all a little bit of insight of what you'll find inside, right? Really important to understand what we feed ourselves and what's happening out there. And I understand that many of you don't know me, but those that do, I expect to have a review ready, and we'll do that at the book signing as well. So those of you who have pre-ordered your copies and have read the book, please come out to the book signing and we will video your reviews. Now, let's dig inside. One of the things that we talk about in the book are words. Words that we hear all the time in our Christian experience, right? So words like commandment, repent, unbelief. We hear all kinds of words, but we don't always understand the meaning of them the way God intended us to understand them. That's what I bring out in the book. Well, I just want to share with you a little bit about how that looks. If I say the word commandment to you, what is the first thing that you hear or that you think? Go ahead, take some time. Okay, so some of the first things people have said that they thought was, I'm in trouble. Some people said, something you gotta do, authority. Some people said, you better do it. Some people said, it's instructions. And even one person said, sucker. So it helped me understand that people, how they relate to the words that they hear. And so I wanted to help you understand, when God gave his word commandment, what was he really saying? And there are five different definitions for the word commandment in the Old Testament. In the book, we're only going to talk about two. One in particular, the word commandment, it's a Greek word, mitzvah, and it means God's prescribed way of thinking. That's it. The laws, the word of God, the tablet that Moses had to chisel out the second time. All it means is God was giving his people his way of thinking about something. So when we say follow the Ten Commandments, we're not saying follow the Ten Instructions, follow the Ten Laws, or you're going to get in trouble. No. What we're saying is follow those Ten of Thinking. And that's the most important part. Now, if you're like me, you grew up in church, and sometimes you didn't get that, right? You got a smack on the hand, if you will. So Adam and Eve, when they were in the Garden of Eden, I learned it, or understood it, or interpreted it. What I heard was, Adam and Eve, you were bad because you ate the fruit. Don't eat that fruit. If you eat of that fruit, you're going to get it with it. On the day you eat of it, you shall surely die. That's how I heard it. That's how my ears interpreted it. But may I submit to you, that's not how God intended it. Actually, what he intended was, what you're really getting is, this is my prescribed way of thinking. I'm going to give you everything in the land, as far as your eyes can see, as far as your imagination can take you, it's yours. Just don't eat of that tree over there. Now, I have children, and when they were little, and they would go close to that stove, I would say, hot. Immediately, they would back away. I didn't go into some long dissertation. Oh, little one, please don't touch the oven. It's hot. You see the red glow? The red glow means it's hot. Oh, back up, because if you don't and you put your hand on it, I didn't do all that, right? I gave them a quick they would observe, it would save their life. I submit to you that's exactly what God did for us. He just showed us his prescribed way of thinking about things. It was like him going into the garden and saying, "Hot, don't touch it." Now, some of you may wonder why they have a commandment in the first place. It was only Adam and Eve there. Why did God give them a commandment? And I submit to you that he gave them a commandment because he wanted them to know three things. One, he wanted to protect them. And so God was giving them this instruction, this one instruction, to protect them. Two, he gave it to them so they would understand his way of thinking. Three, he gave it to them so they would. Three, he gave it to them so they would know. Three, he gave it to them for power of choice. Because without the power of choice, they would all be robots. They'd have to do what God said. God didn't want that. So the three reasons were protection. They'd understand how God thought about it. And they'd have the power of choice. That's the same thing God is doing with you today. He's giving you the power of choice. He's giving you his prescribed way of thinking about something. He's showing you that I am here to protect you. My word is here to protect you. It's not here to punish you or make you do something. That's not the case at all. Actually, it's here to join us together so we can partner. And on earth as it is in heaven, you can fulfill the will and word of the Lord Jesus Christ in this earth right now. Because as he is, so are we in this world. And he says, I've given you everything that pertains to life and godliness now. So what God is really saying to you is, if you take my commandment, or if you take my prescribed way of thinking about things, you will have life and that more abundantly. What he was telling Adam and Eve in the garden is, if you do not take my prescribed way of thinking, if you disobey my prescribed way of thinking, the results of that will be death. He wasn't saying, I'm going to come down like lightning and thunder and strike you down dead. He was saying, if you disobey, or if you sin, or if you think in a way that opposes the way God thinks, the results will be death. And he didn't want that for Adam and Eve. He doesn't want that for you and me. Therefore, when we think like God, when we understand God's prescribed way of doing something, then we can have that life and that more abundantly. All those mental stresses that come to us, all the being overwhelmed and overpowered, and we feel like we cannot go on, we feel anxious, we understand that we have all these bills, all these situations, our parents are ailing, our children are ailing, we have all these things happening in our lives, yet we don't understand how to connect the authority of God and his promises. How do we get from point A to point B? Well, I submit to you, as we think like God thinks, as we understand how God understands a thing, as we begin to see it like God sees it, therefore, as we begin to apply it the way God applies it, we can understand our original mind and be set free. Then, that's life, and life more abundantly. So thank you. Tune in next time for one of the other words that we'll get out of Think Like God, understanding your original mind.